Now, we are going to discuss about invoking the testng.xml from the pom.xml, right? So to do that, go to the pom.xml. And in the pom.xml, okay, you have to add a plugin. You have to add another plugin to make sure that we can able to invoke the testng.xml. For that, so open the Google page and type testng invocation from pom, and you can see a couple of links. Choose Maven Surefire plugin using testng. Right click and click on the, you know, open that in a new window. Go to here, and you know, you can see a couple of already available plugins. What you have to do is go here using suit XML files. Okay, this is the one we need. Take this plugin, copy it, and you need to paste under your pom.xml. Okay, you should not paste it immediately. So you have to first create a build tag. Okay, and inside the build tag, you need to create another plugins tag, okay, under which you have to keep your plugin. Okay, so under the plugins, under the build, you have to keep your plugin tag. Okay, and if you carefully observe that, it is pointing to the testng.xml that is available in your project. So in case if the file name is something else, it's not testng.xml, it is something testng_all.xml or whatever it is. Okay, you have given some custom name. In that case, make sure that whatever the file you wanted to invoke, it is available, it is kept with the same name here also. Okay, if the file name is not testng.xml, it is something else, make sure that the same file name you are giving under suit XML file tag. Okay, so that's all about invoking the testng.xml from the pom. So let's run this and make sure it is working fine. And now I'm going to invoke pom.xml. Let's run the Maven test. Let's see. Okay, fine. So I expected this problem. It says that compilation error. No compiler is provided in this environment. Okay, so for the pom.xml, we have not given any compiler plugin. Okay, so in order to compile stuff from the pom.xml and execute the testng.xml, okay, we need to provide a Maven compiler plugin. It is clearly saying that Maven compiler plugin 3.1 compile, that is default compile. Okay, changes detected, recompile in the module, but somehow it is got failed. We have to clearly mention the Maven plugin. Maven compiler plugin we have to mention. And for that, again, take a new page. You have to write the script one time. Okay, once you write the script for any project, for any Selenium project, okay, this is the same script you are going to reuse it. Maven compiler. Okay, so you can see Apache Maven compiler plugin. Go here. Just click on compile using a different JDK. Not this one. Yeah, take this one, that is take this plugin. Copy this particular plugin under the plugin. Okay, now let's give the source. to 1.8 or 1.7, whatever it is. Okay, make sure from where I get this value. Java minus version. Let's check your version, Java version in your system. I'm using 1.8. Okay, let's make sure you give the 1.8. If you are using somebody using 1.7, okay, it's better to use 1.7 here itself. Okay, so whatever the Java version that you are using, it is better to mention the same thing here. Now I think we are ready for execution. Let's take this pyweb.xml and run it. Run as maventest. Okay, and these are the plugins, right? These are the plugins which we have used. Now let's run this by using run as maventest. So let's make sure that it is working fine now. Sure file is a third party Maven plugin which can be used to execute your testng.xml. This plugin is used to execute your testng.xml. We have given the source 1.8 and target 1.8, and also we kept the Maven compiler plugin, but let's see, there are some problems shown here. So let's see that project configuration is not up to date with pyweb.xml. okay, so it could be chance that this is the reason we are unable to execute the Maven project. Okay, so let's follow the steps. It says that project configuration is not up to date with pyweb.xml, select Maven update project. Okay, so go to the project, right click, select Maven update project, click on OK. So it's building something, updating the Maven project. Okay, now things are fine. Now let's execute once again and make sure it is working fine. Run as Maven test. Though we provided the Maven compiler, it is still asking us to provide the compiler once again. The reason could be it is not built properly because there is some error, and we corrected that error. Let's see, it should work now. Looks it is working fine. It is running the test. Remember, we are running from pyweb.xml. pyweb.xml is in turn referring the testng.xml with the help of Surefire plugin. Okay, if somebody asks you how do you execute testng.xml from the pyweb.xml, you have to say with the help of Surefire plugin. Yeah, so the test execution is completed, and let's go to the project from the file explorer. Let's go to that project. So this is the automation. How can I go to the project location? If you right click, you can see under the resource, you can see the location of the project. Copy this. okay, and open the command, that is Windows R. When you type Windows R, you can see something run command. Type the path and click on OK. And this is the, so this is where our project is available. Go to the target and you can see that show file reports. Okay, click on this one, and here you can see index.html. You can open with Firefox or Chrome, whatever it is. Yeah, so there are two methods, one failed, one passed. Okay, so yeah, there is something failed here, expecting error message but not found. Okay, there is some assertion error, could be the project, the website error message might be changed, and that's the reason it might be failing. Okay, we have to correct it later. That's fine, but we are able to execute the testng.xml from the Maven, from the Maven, that is from the pvm.xml. And for doing that, you need two plugins. One is Surefire plugin, which will take the testng.xml as the input and it will execute it. Okay, and you also require to provide another plugin, that is Maven compiler plugin. Okay, for that you have to give the source and target based on the version that you already installed. I'm installed 1.8, so that's the reason I given source is 1.8 and target is 1.8. if you are installed with 1.7, you can better choose 1.7. so that's all about invoking the testng.xml from the pvm.xml.